I had the craziest dream last night. I was dancing the White Swan. It was different choreography, though. It was more like the Bolshoi's. It was the prologue when Rothbard cast a spell. Look how pink, so pretty.
Pretty.
You're in a good mood.
Mm-hmm. He promised to feature me more this season.
Well, he certainly should. You've been there long enough. And you're the most dedicated dancer in the company.
Up.
What's that?
What?
There.
Nothing.
Sure you don't want me to come with you? You sweet girl.
Today? I can't believe she's back.
Of course she's back.
What, she can't take a hint?
Company's broke.
No one comes to see her anymore.
Nobody actually comes to see ballet, full stop.
That's not true. I heard the Royal had one of their best seasons yet.
He just needs to try something new, that's all.
No. Someone new.
Like hey.
Like someone who's not approaching menopause.
It's sad.
What's sad?
Beth's such a beautiful dancer.
Yeah, so is my grandmother.
Well, Fontaine danced into her 50s.
Yeah, we know.
Hey. Oh, is that Louis?
Great. I fucking miss my stop.
Had to hoof it all the way from 79.
Hey.
Beautiful is always Nina.
Relax.
And one, and two, and three, and four, and... Stop, John. 1 second. Okay, take position, and one, and three and up. One and two and three and four.
We all know the story. Virginal girl, pure and sweet, trapped in the body of a swan. She desires freedom, but only true love can break the spell. Her wish is nearly granted in the form of a prince. But before he can declare his love, her lustful twin, the Black Swan, tricks and seduces him. Devastated, the White Swan leaps off a cliff, killing herself, and in death, finds freedom.